مرافق مالبري. نجاح لوجستي بغزو نورماندي عام 1944.
D-Day, the invasion of Normandy in 1944 during World War II was an enormous logistical undertaking. The coordination between three countries, thousands of ships, tanks, armored vehicles, aircraft, and troops to invade the beachheads of Normandy, France, had to be precisely planned and executed in order to win the battle.
كان التخطيط الدقيق والتنسيق الفائق بين كل هذه العناصر من أهم المفاتيح لتحقيق النصر في معركة الغزو.
To facilitate supplying the Allies with their needs, the British designed, manufactured, and assembled a great feat of engineering called artificial harbors. An artificial harbor was a portable temporary harbor developed to facilitate rapid offloading of cargo onto the beaches during the Allied invasion of Normandy. Codenamed Mulberry, these artificial harbors played an important role in the largest amphibious landing in history.
وقد لعبت دورا شديد الأهمية في أكبر عملية إنزال برمائية في التاريخ. ساهمت أربعة.
There were four logistics principles that contributed to the planning, preparation, and success of these harbors.
الاستجابة.
Responsiveness. The right support at the right place at the right time.
المرونة.
Flexibility. The ability to adapt logistical support to changing situations.
القدرة على الإدامة.
Sustainability.
أي القدرة على إدامة.
The ability to maintain logistical support in combat operations. And
وأخيراً القدرة على
survivability.
أي القدرة
the ability of the organization to protect the logistics lines of support.
كان على مخططي العملية.
The operations planners had to overcome several logistics issues to ensure a victory.
فكان من اللازم أن تستطيع المرافق.
The artificial harbors had to withstand strong winds and handle 10,000 tons of supplies and 2,500 vehicles every day.
2,500 مركبة كل يوم. بسبب الفارق
الكبير. The vast 7-meter differences between high and low tides along the coast meant that the landing crafts would have to dock, unload, and wait for the next tide to become afloat again, which made them vulnerable to attack.
تطفو مرة أخرى. مما جعلها معرضة للهجوم. إضافة إلى هذه العوائق.
Adding to these obstacles was the German Atlantic Wall. Adolf Hitler ordered the construction of a system of military defensive fortifications all along the Dutch, Belgian, and French coasts facing the English Channel. With all ports and facilities under German control, this created an enormous supply and resupply problem for the massive invading forces.
إمداد وإعادة إمداد ضخمة لقوات الغزو الهائلة الحجم.
The wall was composed of small fortified strongholds, barbed wire trenches, and more than 6 million land and sea mines along the coast. Concrete reinforced pillboxes along the coastline with machine and anti-tank guns were installed to cripple landing craft before they could unload personnel and gear. The beaches of Normandy were located between two German defensive battalions, and it was decided those beaches provided the best opportunity of success for the invasion. Plans were developed under which an amphibious landing operation would take place on the day of the battle, followed by military reinforcements over 3 weeks. After the beachheads were secured, the commencement of Allied operations could safely begin. With no Allied harbors available to dock and offload the ships, the British solution was to bring the Mulberries and ports with the invasion force. There were two Mulberries constructed at Normandy. Each of them had four main elements. A breakwater was made of a chain of giant concrete caissons, 60 meters long by 18 meters high by 15 meters wide.
وعرضها 15 مترا ووزنها 7 طن.
Each weighed 7,000 tons.
بعد أن تم وضعها في أماكنها.
After they were maneuvered into place, the valves were opened, allowing them to fill with water, and were sunk into position. These caissons formed a primary breakwater from the 1 to 2 meter sea swells.
من متر إلى مترين.
A second breakwater was formed by sinking old, out-of-use merchant vessels and warships to form a harbor. Pierheads were designed to anchor onto the seabed, which could adjust up and down with the ebb and flow of the tides. British Prime Minister Winston Churchill played an important role in supporting the development and construction of mobile prefabricated harbors. In one of his statements that attracted attention and resources for the Mobile Harbors project, he said, "Piers for the use on beaches, they must float up and down with the tide. The anchor problem must be mastered. Let me have the best solution worked out. Don't argue the matter. The difficulties will argue for themselves." Bridging the gap from the pierheads to the shore were the rhino ferries and floating roadways. The rhino ferries were 12 by 54 meter flat-bottomed pontoon barges, which transported troops and vehicles to the shores. Floating roadways were constructed of whale bridges supported by steel or concrete floats, which carried a 3-meter wide steel deck roadway. 3 kilometers of whale bridge spans were installed at the Omaha Beach Harbor. A completed Mulberry Harbor consisted of 600,000 tons of concrete between 33 jetties and had 15 kilometers of floating roadways to carry troops, vehicles, and supplies to the beach. The huge project began in Great Britain a year before D-Day, employing over 500 organizations and 25,000 individuals. Several manufacturing efforts were distributed along the coast, and most of the caissons were built on the rivers Thames and Clyde. In total, 150 caissons, 23 pierheads, 16 kilometers of floating roadway, and 23 bridges were manufactured. The prefabricated parts were floated down the rivers along the coast to Portsmouth and were placed in staging areas near the Isle of Wight, where they were assembled and awaited the 160-kilometer journey across the English Channel. The movement across the English Channel was complex and difficult due to the weather and the logistics of the task. The artificial harbors were towed across at 8 kilometers per hour directly behind the invasion force. At the beginning of the invasion, most of the artificial harbors' floating caissons were placed at a distance of 10 kilometers from the French coast. The 2 mulberries were constructed off the beaches of Omaha and Arromanche and completed on June 9th, only 3 days after D-Day. Both were fully functional in 9 days. During initial operations, supplies and gear flowed to the beach. Over the course of 10 days, more than 4,000 supply vessels, most of which were unable to unload on the beaches, crossed the channel back and forth to securely and competently resupply, even in the most difficult climatic conditions. The transfer of huge amounts of material, up to 14 tons per day, consisted of a huge inventory of supplies, equipment, and accessories. On 19 June, severe storms hit the area, causing the artificial harbor at Omaha Beach to collapse. 21 of the 31 caissons anchored in place could not be repaired. At that point, the Americans quickly switched to landing aircraft and were able to continue logistics operations. Due to its condition, the decision was made not to repair the Mulberry. However, spare parts were recovered to ensure the continued operation of the remaining one. This harbor named Port Winston at Arromanche saw wide use over 8 months until the capture and reopening of the French ports, such as Cherbourg. During this period, it transferred 2.5 million soldiers, 500,000 vehicles, and 4 million tons of Allied supplies. The underwater pipeline known as Pluto was dedicated to fuel supply. It was installed and engineered with the artificial harbor to ensure that the Allies did not run out of fuel. When the port of Cherbourg was taken, the Allies built the first of multiple pumping stations in France to fuel their advance towards Berlin. Comparing the artificial harbors and the Atlantic Wall's defenses after the war, Hitler's chief engineer Albert Speer said, to construct our defenses we had in 2 years, used 13 million cubic meters of concrete and 1.5 million tons of steel. A fortnight after the landings by the enemy, this costly effort was brought to nothing because of an idea of simple genius. As we know now, the invasion forces brought their own harbors and built at Arromanches and Omaha, on unprotected coast, the necessary landing ramps.
وقامت ببناء أرصفة الإنزال الضرورية على ساحل مكشوف غير محمي في أرومانش وأومها. الاستجابة
Responsiveness
والمرونة
Flexibility
والقدرة على الإدامة
Sustainability
والقدرة على البقاء
and Survivability.
برزت
These principles of logistics were clearly demonstrated in the construction of the supply routes from Great Britain to France. The Battle of Normandy was tactical and logistical. The artificial harbor concept was the key that led to the Allied victory in Western Europe during World War II.